Did you say something?
Nothing. I'll put her down.
Resident Evil Village, aka Resident Evil 8. This game came out about 6 months ago, and it is a direct sequel to Resident Evil 7. It looks and plays exactly like that one, so it's still that narrow field of view, first-person game. And you even play as Ethan Winters, the same character that you played as in 7. I did not realize this going in when this game came out. I took more of a technical look at it just to see what the game looked like, especially the castle interior areas. But I didn't like read any reviews or look too much into it. I knew it was a game, once the price dropped, I was going to buy it. And so going in, yeah, I was completely surprised to find out that you're still playing as Ethan Winters, and this is a direct sequel to Resident Evil 7. If you liked 7, you're going to like this one. I would say I like it just as much as I like 7, maybe even more. Maybe I'm just saying that because I'm playing it now and I'm really excited about it. But this game just, it gets better and better. Like when I first got into this game, when I first got to the castle, I was like, I don't know, this seems kind of cheesy. You know, the way the characters were introduced, I didn't know if I was going to like it, but it just got better and better and better. Yeah, I'm really loving this game, and I'm glad I waited, because not only did the game drop, like the game was pretty expensive when it came out, and I ended up picking it up for like $40 Canadian on Steam. Also when this game launched on PC, there was a lot of performance issues. And I would say it seems like they got that all ironed out. My biggest complaints with this game are typical with Resident Evil games on PC. The menus and some of the settings, it's very obvious that this was a console game first, and PC was a bit of an afterthought. All the Resident Evil games are like this. So, for example, I don't even have my Xbox One controller turned on. And yet, as soon as I go into controls, it's showing me a picture of an Xbox controller. And, you know, where's obvious things like mouse sensitivity? This game's got a very low mouse sensitivity. You've got to move the mouse to another zip code to get your character just to turn like 90 degrees. And I can't see a way to change that in the game. You can turn the DPI up on your mouse, but then your mouse cursor is going to be flying all over the screen when you go into the menus. So it's like a little odd, right? But then you get into the graphics settings, and it's even worse. First of all, there's a setting in here for interlaced graphics modes. I do not understand this. I've seen this in other Resident Evil games. I think in Resident Evil Remake 2 and probably in Resident Evil 7. What modern PC games have interlaced mode? I don't understand that. And the graphics preset options are very strange. Instead of having like low, medium, high, and ultra, like literally every other PC game, you've got a number system between 0.5 and 2. So in my mind, 0.5 is low, 1 is medium, 1.5 is high, and 2 is ultra. But you can change it by 0.1. So like you can set it to 1.4. or 1.6. Seems a little much, but you know, these are minor complaints because, like I said, this game looks great and it runs great. I'm just running this on a mid-range AMD Radeon RX 5600 XT 6GB GPU. It's not a high-end graphics card, and yet the game is running fine. I'm running it at high settings, 1.5 at 1440p, and it's running at about 55 frames per second, but I've got a FreeSync monitor. I've got VSync turned off in the game, so there's no like latency on waiting for the frame rate to sync up. There's no screen tearing issues. It looks and runs fine, and there's not even slowdown in certain areas, which I think initially when this game launched, even if you had a really high-end GPU, the game would run, you know, really well most of the time, but there was like certain areas where even on a high-end GPU you would have slowdown. I'm not seeing that. I'm not getting any stutter. The game's just running pretty consistently the whole time, so that's pretty good. And even on like setting 1.5 without like ray tracing, the game looks incredible. Apparently, go figure. Apparently, some of the early performance issues with this game on PC were because of the DRM. It kind of paid off to wait 6 months because I got the game for less than half price. The game, like I said, was pretty expensive when it launched. And so I got it for less than half price, and it seems like they got all the performance issues ironed out. So if you were worried about playing this game on PC, I would say don't worry about it. Again, it's running great for me, even on a 5600 XT 6GB GPU. But, you know, the game's also on Xbox Series X and PS5. So if you've got one of those consoles, you know, I don't really think it matters how you play it. If you want to play it with a controller, that's probably fine. Again, the game has a really narrow field of view, and it's not, like, super fast-paced most of the time. I mean, there are times, obviously, where you want to be able to get a headshot really quickly, but it's very doable. I'm playing the game on medium difficulty, and I don't know, maybe my another small complaint I would have, the boss fights seem kind of easy.
Your bullets cannot harm. You stupid.
Especially the unusually tall vampire lady. I cannot pronounce that last name properly, so I'm not even going to try anymore. I remember that boss fight. I was thinking to myself, I'm not doing very good. But I still ended up beating her first try. And on like medium settings for a Resident Evil game, that's a little strange. I remember playing Resident Evil 5, and on some of those boss fights, you know, maybe I died a couple of times. You know, especially the first time, you're kind of figuring out what to do, and you know you're going to do better the second time. But to just kind of breeze through it on medium set, on like medium difficulty, this is a little strange for a Resident Evil game. So I don't know, maybe it's a little too easy, even on medium. And I mean, I am not like a hardcore gamer. So if I'm saying that, you know, again, I kind of expect to die on a boss fight when it's my first time. And especially if I feel like I'm not doing very well, I haven't figured out the patterns or the secret right away, and I, you know, I figure I'm gonna die and then I'll do better the second try. But again, a little easy in this one. But I mean, the game looks amazing. And the atmosphere is amazing. The weapons are fun to upgrade, and the enemies are fun. It's just, wow. It's a really good game. I'm really, really enjoying it. So, again, Resident Evil Village, if you haven't checked it out, now's the time. It's finally on sale at a reasonable price. Again, I think the game was like $100 Canadian when it came out, so you know, $40 for a game of, it's not a very long game. I think it's like 10 hours. So like $100 for a 10 hour game. Yeah, no thanks. Again, I waited. I usually wait for games to go on sale anyways. And hey, it was probably worth the wait, especially on PC. So anyways, Resident Evil Village, great game. Check it out.